Everyone, this is Trucker Wayne on Facebook, Wayne Craig on LinkedIn, here with Pam Transport. How's everybody doing today? Don't forget, if you're looking for a CDL job, you can go to PamDrivingJobs.com. You can put in, let's say you live in Dallas and you're looking for a job in Dallas. You don't have to be a Pam employee. You can put in Dallas, and PamDrivingJobs.com will alert you in your inbox if there's a job showing up in Dallas. It's that simple. The last in my series of winter driving tips. Last one, but I always say whenever I say it, and I said it, I get pushback every time, even from the people with 20 and 30 years. I never minded to chain and go. The company that I used to work with, first thing in orientation, it'd say, do you know where chain and go? And if you don't want to do it, it's okay. Some people would walk out. They don't want nothing to do with it. It's all right. My feeling is that I didn't really care much. Places like Colorado, and I'm going to tell a quick story about Colorado. They on I-70, a lot of times you're going to need them chains at times to actually run and get over that hill there, right? But I'll tell you a story how I believe. My belief is chain never bothered me that much, but I was trying always not to chain legally. I did use it, this right here. Use that right there. Because I delivered one time, or I should say, I picked up in Denver on a Friday. We always did our resets on Friday or Saturday. It was a done deal. You had to do a reset, not recap the company I was flatbedding with. And I knew anybody that knows in the wintertime, if you're going into Denver in the wintertime, and then I was going west, I-70, you know there is a chance, more than likely chance, that you're going to be chained up if you're going to move to get over that hill. And sure enough, it was actually snowing in Denver. If it's snowing in Denver, you know, depending on where a storm's coming from, it's snowing up in the mountains. And sure enough, I got loaded, tarped it about 2 o'clock. There's two TAs, I believe, still, if I remember right, in Denver. I think it's the TA West Denver I stopped at. I figured it was about 2:30, 3 o'clock, something like that. And I'd do the math later on Sunday, because I figured, hey, I'll just do my reset here. There were chain laws on I-70 because of the snow. So I thought, you know, I'll just wait and see what happens on Sunday. See if the storm will pass, see if I can get lucky. Maybe if I don't get lucky, I'll be chaining up and getting over the hill. Well, or they would just close I-70. And nowadays, even in Wyoming, they're starting to close these roads way more quickly than used to, because people would get in accidents and serious injuries and even death. All right, so I, at that time, and now there's better ways of doing it, but I used to get emails on, I had it everywhere from all the western states, and I'd get updates from Colorado about when chain laws were going in and out of effect on the things, and all the emails would alert me. Well, my reset was up at like 2 or 2:30, something like that, on that Sunday. Whatever time I stopped on Friday, it was like 2 or 2:30. I got my 70 hours back. And lo and behold, at 1:30 in the morning on Sunday, they had had the chain laws from Friday, Saturday. And then about 1:30, they lifted the chain law up there in the mountains. Well, we had had, that was when, back then, truckers actually would talk, and not, they don't do much of that anymore in the lounge. But we all talked, and there were some really, really adamant drivers like, don't ever take off at night going over that hill. A lot of them are like, I don't chain. I'm sitting there just in my head. I have my way to give my opinion here, so I don't sit there and argue with anyone at a truck stop. Even back then, I was thinking, I'm going to try to be a, you know, outsmart this thing. Use this up here. So I got the alert at 1:30. And 2 o'clock, 2:30, whatever, my reset was up, and I did my pre-trip, and I was gone. I was like, I don't really care, it's the middle of the night. These guys are serious. Those officers are serious on I-70 in the wintertime, and if they lifted the chain law, well, I'm going. I don't want a chain. That was my whole thing. I don't want a chain. Nobody else left with me. Nobody. It was me, lonely old Wayne, and there was a few drivers that, not at the TA, but there was a few of us that actually got that word out, and we're heading up the hill. And then there's the way station they always stop you at, and they pulled us all in there. They got to make sure you have your chain. So I asked the officer, sir, did I have my chains? And he knew Central Oregon have all their chains, but he had to check. I said, sir, we were all talking down at the truck stop down there, and when you lifted the chain law, I got up, my reset's on, I'm up here. Would you recommend that? Because everyone down there was saying, the majority of the people were saying they'd never drive in the night up the hill. And he said, quote, I wish more people would do what you're doing because it's supposed to snow again at 9 or 10. And sure enough, you know, we're just going to slap the chain laws back on. We wish more people would pay attention, get over this hill. You don't need your chains. He goes, it'd be a lot easier for you all. Okay, thanks. And I didn't have to slap my chains out all the way. You know when it evens out farther down there when you get close to Utah. Listen, everyone, right there. I don't want to chain. I wasn't opposed to chaining. But those people that sat down there and refused, I'm not going to chain. If it means chain, I'm not going to move. Well, by the time they woke up on Sunday morning, they had the chain laws again. I'm just telling you, everyone. I'm just telling you. I wasn't smarter than anybody else. All this information's out there. I grab it and I make decisions. And I'm saying I am going to head up there. And, you know, his recommendation was, they take these things seriously. So if they're gonna, if at 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, the chain laws go out of effect and I got my 70 back, I'm hauling. And it's just to say, if you need change, you ain't gonna move. Well, what about all the other stuff in between? That's all I'm saying. So this is Trucker Wayne on Facebook, Wayne Craig on LinkedIn with Pam Transport. Remember to check out, and by the way, this is not, by the way, Pam, when I talk about winter tips, they're my tips. I work with Pam, so just going over some things there. So this is something where the company may have a different view on that. I'm just saying, if you're heading out west and you're a Pam Transport driver, always be smart. I'm still around. You got to be smart in situations. So, hey, remember to go to PamDrivingJobs.com. I'm out.